Dobre dan. First of all, I would like to welcome you all to Bled. For me, it's not the first time to be in Slovenia, because I spend every year my holidays on the other side of the mountains, in the beautiful valley of Soča, for kayaking and for hiking. To my person, my name is Stefan Neumann. I'm working for the company of Baumet, an Austrian building material company, also with branches in Slovenia. And I try to establish the design of semi-rigid pavement. Baumet has developed a mortar, or rather a concrete, and an easy logistics, which supports the processing of the semi-rigid pavement. Does any one of you already build or design a semi-rigid pavement in Slovenia? Okay. No? Of course. Okay, one. Okay. Okay, so I think it was the right decision to come to Bled today. At first, I want to explain you what a semi-rigid pavement is. It's a mixture with an asphalt and a concrete. It's combined the advantages of the asphalt, so it's flexible as asphalt, and also the advantages of concrete, so it's resistant against deformation like concrete. Basically, a semi-rigid pavement is the top layer of an asphalt pavement. The finished semi-rigid pavement consists of two components: a porous asphalt and the mortar. To my content, I will start with an overview of the history of semi-rigid pavements. Then I explain you the two components you need, the properties of the layer, the processing steps, and at the end, a conclusion and some examples for applications. To the history. Already in the 1970s, there were first test sections for semi-rigid pavement, and the idea was to combine the positive properties of the concrete with those of the asphalt. However, the mortar technology was not really developed at the time, so the voids of the porous asphalt could not fill up with mortar. It came to poorly or not at all mortared layers. Cracking and under damages were the results. And as a result of this, the construction was very limited used and developed. The development stopped for a long time. In the last 15 years, the building materials industry has massively improved the properties of the mortar, and so the semi-rigid pavement was rediscovered. In Germany, in 2001, a leaflet was issued for the production of a semi-rigid pavement, in which clear installation rules were specified. In Austria, such a guideline of rules was still missing so far. Therefore, starting in 2012, a team of road construction specialists began to developing a guideline for semi-rigid pavements. Due to the development of special high-performance mortars, the use of semi-rigid pavement is now increasing massively. The first component of a semi-rigid pavement is very similar to normal asphalt. You need an asphalt, you need a paver, you need a compactor. But the main difference is the void content of the porous asphalt on the top layer. You have a content of 24 to 30% after compaction. So many words. So it is important to have a focus on the grain shape, which you use the aggregate in the asphalt. A cubic form is perfect. The second component of the semi-rigid pavement is the mortar, which can also be titled as a concrete. The quality of the mortar is ruled in an Austrian standard. The compressive strength of the mortar is chosen that it flows 1 hour like water. That's important for the processing. And after 24 hours, you can reach 20 newt per square millimeter or 20 megapascal. It's available in different colors. And normally, you need no joints like in normal concrete because the mortar and also the layer has a very low shrinkage. That means it does not shorten like normal concrete. The finished layer, the semi-rigid pavement, has a lot of advantages compared to normal asphalt or to normal concrete. So it's possible to get different surfaces. You can polish it. You have much lower joints in the construction, about 90% lower as in concrete. You have a very fast traffic availability, normally 24 hours. Highest load capacity, absolutely tight frost, de-icing resistant, resistant against acid, against fuels and other chemical materials. Fire resistant, and the highest durability. The compressive strength after 28 days is 10 newton per square millimeter. That's the compressive strength of the layer, okay? Not the mortar. Do you think this is enough for roads or other infrastructure areas? I have some examples. A wheel of a car, normally you have 0.25 newt, a truck 0.8, a plane 1.6, but the biggest load that you can have is a stiletto high heel. A semi-rigid pavement can handle even this load. To the processing steps. The use of a semi-rigid pavement is possible on newly built surfaces, on a new binder layer, for example, or in rehabilitation of existing asphalt layers. In this case, the old asphalt surface must be milled down and cleaned to match a constant thickness of the new layer. It is not allowed to compensate holes with the porous asphalt. The semi-rigid pavement can fully develop its static effect only with a sufficient composite. It is essential to pre-spray the surface of the base with enough amount of bitumen emulsion before applying the porous asphalt. The installation of the asphalt is done with a Norman asphalt paver. A manual installation is also possible, but must be practiced. The finished installation height is 4 to 6 centimeters, depending on the grain size. You can use 8, 11, or 16 millimeter grain size porous asphalt. And the elevation after the paver should be 3 millimeters. After the installation, the asphalt has to be slightly compacted. It is important. It's important to compress only with static and to use no vibration during the rolling, otherwise necessary cavities are destroyed. The rolling is only used to flatten the surface and to make the connections between the asphalt tracks plan. At higher asphalt temperatures, the mortar stiffens too fast. Less filling of cavities and reduced strength of the semi-liquid pavement occur. This leads to cracks, therefore the porous asphalt should be protected from sun and rain at higher temperatures with a white foil. After cooling, the high-performance mortar is filled. I will check the video. Is filled with a hose from a silo coming from a mixer and a pump, which are fixed on the silo. You can distribute the mortar with a rubber lip puller, and a nice surface appearance results from peeling off with a new puller and even pressure. For smaller construction sites, it makes sense to work with bags and a plaster machine or a hand mixer. It is important to protect the freshly filled asphalt against too rapid dehydration, and therefore you should have a look at the aftercare of the semi-rigid pavement. That's really very important. Especially at high outside temperature, a good aftercare is very important for the quality of the semi-rigid pavement. The table on the slide shows the necessary aftercare work according to the temperature and solar radiation. It's also published in the Austrian guideline for semi-rigid pavements. From a temperature of over 30 degrees, the risk of cracks increasing massively. The traffic release normally after 24 hours. At lower temperatures, the release of traffic may be extended up to 3 days due to the slower development of the strength of the mortar. If required, the traffic release can also be carried out on the basis of a successfully pressure strength test on cylinders which are stored on the building site. It's also important to have a focus on the design of the joints and the connections. Basically, a semi-rigid pavement does not require any joints. Depending on the installations, for example, shafts or inlet grills, and the geometry, it may be useful to form joints at the least 12 hours after installation of the mortar on the total thickness of the layer. Of course, these must be chosen, must be closed by permanent elastic material. All connections must be tight and elastic. For all connections, before you fill in the mortar, make sure that the mortar does not flow out of the porous asphalt or drain into the channel or into deeper layers. Sloped surfaces can be built up to a slope of maximum 8%. For smaller areas, it's also possible to go up to 10%. What we learn after 10 years of experience with our mortar and the construction of a semi-rigid pavement is a lot. We build more than 200 building sites in Austria, and it was very important to keep an eye on the weather. And a harder mortar results not a harder pavement. We are making We made tests in our laboratories with mortars with a very high strength, but there are no results, different results at the end in the layer, so in the semi-rigid pavement. A stiffness and a homogeneous base is very important. And timely preparation of the building size. So have electricity there, have enough water there, with enough water pressure. That's really an important thing. Now I will show you some examples for application. The first one is a bus terminal in the town of Freistadt. It's in the north of Austria. Here we use a colored mortar. Another application example is on a road. It's close to our plant in Wapfing, where we have very heavy traffic coming from trucks. Another application, an underground car park in the city of Linz. It's a very bright surface. Another application at the Med campus in Graz, it's a town close to Marburg. There, the building company use a colored mortar with the color of anthracit. So it looks like an asphalt. And there a truck parking area from the Asfinag in Austria, close to the city of St. Pölten. A storage hall from a trader for building materials in Linz. And here we have an area where landfill materials are storaged, so you need in Austria a dense surface for this material. It's also possible, it's in Wiener Neustadt. Yeah, and I'm now at the end of my presentation, and let me finish say, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me. A summary, a semi-rigid pavement opens new fields for application for asphalt, I think. It's a solution if asphalt is not enough, that can means the strength of the asphalt. And it's a solution for new surfaces, and maybe it can make asphalt more colorful. So thank you very much, especially to Slovenko Henigman for the invitation to this great event. Thank you very much and enjoy your lunch.
Thank you, Stefan. Any questions? Prashanya? I have a question. Okay. I'm sure that you made some skid resistance measurements on those areas with semi-rigid pavement. Skid resistance and texture depth, is it okay?
The measurements about what?
About the friction. Yeah.
Yes, there are some measurements. It's necessary to protect it from too fast dehydration. So it's necessary to spray up a liquid. And after this, you have normally a surface which is not so smooth. Yeah. But this effect ends after 2 or 3 weeks. So normally it depends on the grain, on the stone you use. That's the important influence.
Thank you, because in the article you are mentioning blasting and grinding afterwards, after treatment. Is it necessary? That's blast. What I wrote in your grinding and blasting.
No, it's only when you, it's not necessary for roads or other traffic areas. But if you want to have a special surface, it looks nicer. You can polish it, but it's not necessary.
Thank you.